Good morning, dear YouTube viewers, those who have joined right now here at Dhaka, the capital city of Bangladesh. Today is the 30th of January 2020 and time now is 1100 a.m. Temperature rised up little, about now 23°C and humidity 70%. I am at rooftop. Gentlemen, you can see my Epidendrobium finally bloomed and I am at rooftop, so I can share with you the weather condition. It's little foggy, but still we can see the sun. So it is a bright day, I can say partially bright day, but there was a forecast that there could be a rainy day like yesterday, so I did not water yesterday. So today I am scheduled to do the watering. Gentlemen, this is the continuation video of my previous video I made. I'll give a link below in at this video where I said that the 6 steps of my taking care of my orchids that I encounter. There are 6 stages that I encounter and these all are related to feeding. So I am going to test one of those today and I would like to go with you so that you are with me and can have a look. And if you have any suggestions, points, you can give. I'll try to finish this video within this speculated time. But if I cannot, there makes a split folder. So I'll make it a part one. I'll leave below the link of part two. If you see the title is having part one, then you must find the link of part two at the description box. So let's start. Normally, what I do, I keep notes. What about the feeds I am making? Say today I have fed Vanda. The red color is showing the bloom fertilizer. So I have fed Vanda today. Now what I am planning to do is feeding these particular plants which I have dual media. Dual media I want to mean I purchased them during this winter season. They have this portion they have coconut chips and this is inorganic media. So this is dual. So I have to take care about this hydration of these two. This should not get too dry and this should not remain too wet. If it is too wet like this, I must not soak it. I must not put any water. If it is remain dry, I must give water here. So I am now planning to select plants from here and then make it a soak in this big bucket. This bucket contains, I have purchased new, it has got a wheel here, you can see these are the wheels, so I can pull and push with this. And this bucket contains about 40 liters of water. At this moment there are 40 liters of water. So this will be a normal nutrition, no fertilizer using. Normal nutrition. So how I am going to do it, let me share with you. So this is day 24 2. This was day 24 1 Vanda. So today is 24 2. 24 is the feeding day, not the date. Date is here. So date I should write here now, today 31 20. So this is the date. Now what I am planning today is the RO rain reverse osmosis water starting ppm for me is 30. I must be within 100 to 130 ppm for normal feeding. So I have gone on 30 with my RO water starting ppm. I am now left over with only 100. So 100, I should go for CalMag about more 20. Then I should add some magnesium 10. So it comes 60 ppm. And then I should now give them some seaweed extract, because these are all old plants and they need some nutrition. They have already finished their blooming, So I would give them seaweed extract about, say, 30 ppm. So it becomes 90. I will increase CalMAC to 40. So 70, 80, 80 and 30, 110 ppm. So plus minus 110 ppm, I am going to mix today. So let's go to the mixing point and see the video. Please stay tuned with me. Sorry, I missed one thing. I'll add it up later. I will also add some super dry because these plants are potted after having bloomed and removed from the old pot. So they are in distress, so they need some super dry. So I will add more 10 ppm about super them. So it will become 120. So I have my pH testing meter here, then my TDS meter here. I have some Epsom salt here also. Then I have my CalMAC in this bottle. Then seaweed extract here, super dry here. I have some pH down solution here, acetic acid, and also some pH up here. And then I have this for stirring this, mixing this water. Then what I do, I have a separate container, small container like this, to return down Epsom salt, because the Epsom salt I don't want to pour directly onto this whole mix. I will put Epsom salt here, then from here the solution water I'll put there and test whether it is 10 ppm or not. So let me first put some Epsom salt. Maybe for this 40 liters 10 ppm would be this is good enough for me. Up to this much for 40 ppm is good enough. So now let's start first. So we had the CalMAC about 40 ppm. So let's go with the CalMAC. Normally I do this from dropper like this, but as it is too much of water, about 40 liters of water, I have never mixed such a large or huge volume. So the dropper may not help. Well, let me try. I think 4 times giving will be 40 ppm. Let me see. Test 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time. So it should be now 70 ppm, because 30 is already in my starting ppm. I have already 30. So it should be now 70 ppm. If it is 70 ppm, then I am fine. That means each drop contains about 10 ppm. So let's see. It should be 70 ppm. Remember, it should be 70 ppm. No, much below. It is 40. So much below. I have to pour more few drops to make it a 70. Let's see now. I am doing it in one hand. Please bear with me. So, please bear with me. Let's see now. 60 ppm. So I need little more. So I gave 8 drop makes 40 ppm. That will be total of the 70 ppm at this moment in this water. So it has become 70. See, already 70, you see, 7 is showing 7, 8 into 10. So it has increased by 10. Okay, no problem. So 80 ppm is not bad. I'll take 80 ppm, no problem. 80 ppm is good. Okay, then I'll give super drive. I plan to give 10 ppm, but I am not sure whether I can measure 10 or not, because super drive is very hardy and very difficult to measure it. So I have given few drops. Let's see how much it is. If it is 10 ppm, fine. If it is not, still I'll leave it. I'll not add so much. So it should be 90. It should be 90. No, still it is 80. See, super drive. I have given enough. Still, let me give more because I want 10 ppm. Okay, I think it's okay now. If it takes 10 ppm super drive, I am happy. I am happy to go. Let's see. No, still it is 80. Still, so I leave it. I don't go for 10 ppm because then it will be too much ratio in terms of super drive. And now seaweed. Seaweed, I have a plan of giving about seaweed 30 ppm. So 30 ppm seaweed, I need to give maybe 10 drops. Sorry, 3 drops can make 30 ppm. 3 drops should make 30 ppm. Let's see. If it is 30, then it should be at 80 and 10. 80 and 30 is 110. It should be 110. Let's see. No, still it's 80, much below the level. So let me pour more. I hope you can see well because I'm doing in one hand. It's very difficult doing it one hand. So it become 90. So I have to give more extract, seaweed extract. Why I am giving super drive and seaweed extract? Because all these plants, they are just finished. They have just finished 110. You see, it becomes 110. Sorry, 10, 100. So I have to give more 10. So I have to give more 10. It should be 110. Why I am giving super drive and then seaweed extract? Because 110. So it has become 110. Here is 11. 11 means into 10. You see, it's into 10 in my TDS meter. Is always I have to multiply by 10. So 110. So why I am giving super drive and seaweed extract for these particular plants? Reason behind is they are just finished blooming. You see, still there is one here. I have to cut it off. Here is one. This is one. They have just finished their blooming, and they need some nutrition, some kinds of stress they are undergoing because I removed them from their original pot, and I put them in dual pot. So they need some kinds of nutrition or some kinds of stress relief kinds of stuff for their food, so that they do not undergo heavy stress, because we know super drives, it helps plants to get their strength back in their roots. So this is what I have planned. Now I should check the pH. pH I am not worried about, because I have not used calcium nitrate and magnesium, where I have to be very, very careful so that it does not rise more than 5.8. So now if it is 6.5, I don't mind. 6.8 is reducing. 6.6 6.5 6.5. pH meter, it takes time to show you the correct. When it is dropping down, please wait for some time, because it will continue dropping down, and if it is rising up, it will continue rising up. So it is 6.2. So even it raises 6.1, I hope that it will be within 5.3 or 5.7. Even it raises, if it is dropping down, so I don't mind. So this is the pH. Now I should now select the pot that are good for soaking for today. I shall be selecting now the pots. Those are really good for soaking today. So this one was in the inorganic and organic, both mixed, and I find it is little dry. So this is good to soak.
So I place it here. I place it here. This is good to soak. Then this one is fully inorganic media. So this is good to soak. This is good to soak. This one, it has the inorganic here and organic inside, and the organic is little dry. It's not bone dry, but yet it can take soaking for 10-15 minutes. So I give this one too. So gentlemen, likewise, I have to select all of them, so I don't want to take your time, and I hope you have understood the idea that I am following. So this is how I'll select them and then put them here for about 30 minutes. So after 30 minutes, these 45 liters of water is to be reused or a wastage. So I'm going to reuse them, maybe with these cattleyas. I'll be reusing them because these cattleyas do not need any growth or bloom fertilizer. They just need to be hydration. So that's all that I have planned for today's fertilizing. I have schedule of 10 days interval. So in a month, I have to fertilize 3 times. It makes 30 days, 10, 10, 10. So first 10 days, I fertilize bloom. Second 10 days, I fertilize growth. And third 10 days, again, I fertilize for bloom, for the blooming flowers. Plants, and for the if not blooming, then I don't bloom them. And in third one, I use kelp and seaweed or something of that in nature, or super drive, this thing. That's what I am using now. So gentlemen, stay tuned with me. Please excuse me for my bad pronunciation. Sometimes I am not pronouncing the word that you are used to. Sometimes some local language or the accent coming up, so bear with me and help me, please. If I am making any mistakes, please help me out. Today I have fertilized my vandas well. See my Rhynchostylis gigantea, so nice blooming. I can still hold you for more 3 minutes or 2 minutes for one video. I don't have to go for part two. So I have finished in within part one. I'm so happy that I don't have to go for another folder. So anyway, this is also, and you see my vanda is now spiking. It is spiking. This is one, it is spiking here, you see. This is spiking. And then another foxtail, you can see this is spiking. This is also spiking. So I am getting some achievement in my vanda section. This is my Catasetum mounted one, still not gone for hibernation, dormant, still not gone for dormant. And this is that Sambarkia that I have potted recently, and this is the spikes of the Sambarkia. Anyway, friends, I am almost about to finish the first folder, otherwise I will have to go for the part two. I don't want to go for part two. So please share with me. Bear with me, and if you have any suggestions how you do it, these 6 stages of the difficulties that I am facing with watering my 450 numbers of plants, total 450 numbers of plant at the rooftop. I am really in trouble of giving them feeding for growth, feeding for bloom, and normal nutrition or normal hydrating. These kinds, 3 kinds of feedings, I am really having some trouble. Again, there are some plants, they need blooming fertilizer, some needs growth fertilizer, some needs normal hydration. So I cannot go by shelf. Even I go by shelf, I have to categorize each shelf for 3 kinds of solution. Anyway, friends, stay tuned with me. If you have not subscribed, please do subscribe me. If you subscribe me, I am ready to communicate with you anytime I feel like. So I'm running short of time, only 15 seconds left for one folder to make it a part one only. And please go to the description box to see the 6 stages that I have suffered and suffering. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye bye.